In this tutorial, we will try to explain step by step the bucket tool in MS Paint and the methods, functions, and features of filling a color to a specific area. To get the most out of this training, following this content and our previous and subsequent or other related trainings that we publish in series will help you understand and achieve much more. We open MS Paint and are presented with a clean and blank canvas with a white background color. We usually use the bucket tool to fill a specific area on the canvas with color, but it is also possible to change the color of the entire canvas. With the first color, also known as foreground color, we can change the color of the selected area. To do this, we hover over the area on the canvas with the bucket tool and click with the left mouse button. To fill it with the background color, the second color, we do the same operation, but this time with the right mouse button. With the foreground color black and the background color white, we will now use the bucket tool to paint the canvas first completely black and then white, and with a few repetitions, we will have demonstrated the most general application of the bucket tool. We are going to design a very simple mandala template to show in a simple way what it's like to use the bucket tool to paint a specific area or shape instead of the whole canvas and what we can design with it. When designing a mandala, we first prepare a symmetrical base for the outlines, then create other shapes step by step to develop the design. Since the main lesson is about the bucket tool, in this lesson, we show the mandala design process in an accelerated way. Of course, we plan to publish more different, more detailed and more sophisticated tutorials on mandala design in the future. Once we have created the outline of our clothes bin as a template, we will take a copy and move it to another area on the canvas, and then fill it with various colors with the bucket tool. We start by choosing a different color for the background color on the canvas, instead of white, and changing the background color using the bucket tool. When assigning colors from the bucket tool, it accepts colors other than the specified color as limits. In other words, the bucket tool affects color pixels for all adjacent identical colors until another color arrives. Now, with the eraser, we erase some of the gray ring lines from the outline template so that they don't create borders or obstacles during color filling. Also, when we assign colors with the bucket tool, we remove some outlines so that they are not a boundary or barrier. We place the colors carefully and quickly in the areas we have determined. As we mentioned earlier, to assign a color to a specific area or change its color, we click with the left mouse button on the area on the canvas with the bucket tool selected. If we make a wrong paint fill, we can use the undo option or correct it with the bucket tool by reassigning the color to the same area. Instead of filling our mandala template completely, we filled only a part of it with the bucket tool in a time-lapse manner to serve as an example. And so we have come to the end of this training. If you haven't seen it, we recommend you watch the previous and subsequent tutorials in the series. We will continue the series with more beautiful trainings, and we will be with you again very soon. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.